Right, so it is Sunday, the 6th of March. I'm down in Cornwall, down in the southwest of England, with a big vegetable farming company, Southern England Farms, down here. So we're just setting off their 8-row, 6-metre strip till, SPX. We are going into some work land. It's been shallow cultivated. The main reason is that they're going to run a hoe behind the strip till when the crop is growing, and they want something that make some softer soil. So they've disced it to about 2 inches, and now we're running the strip till down to about 9-10 inches is where we're running it. So this was previously a broccoli crop, and another broccoli crop is going in here. So the strips we are creating, if you can see them, are at 90 centimeters. So this is the second broccoli crop in here. It will be going harvested in July into Tesco's, probably. They supply Tesco's and Sainsbury's, I believe. So you can clearly see the strips here. Like I say, we've got it down quite deep. Give that broccoli every opportunity. So we're down to 10 inches there. Tomorrow there will be 5 planters, so 5 broccoli transplanters following this. So you can see these 3 parked up here. They're automated. They're 4 rows each, and there's 2 big 8 rows will also be coming. So the pressure will be on. We've got a very small weather window. So this 1 meter strip till, this 1 6-meter strip till is basically feeding 5 planters. They've allocated about 2,000 acres to put in off the back of this strip till this year, so they're going to have to work it pretty hard. So I just thought I'd show you this field next door, which is the neighbouring field that they planted with broccoli yesterday. So these are the automated transplanters they use. So they've got 3 of these 4-row automated transplanters and these liquid fert tanks they're putting down with it. They've also got 2 bigger planters, so they'll be running 5 behind the strip till. This is a broccoli, so they're in 12 metre rows, and then these passages through under the plastic. This was previously a broccoli crop, so it's 2 seasons of broccoli. This field was ploughed, then it was deep leg and disc cultivated, then it was power harrowed. So very horsepower hungry operations, and very, very slow, as opposed to in the neighbouring field that we've done that shallow disc just for the inter-row hoe, and hopefully we can stop that. We can get them a hoe that will penetrate unmoved soil, and then just the 1 pass with the strip till only moving about 20 centimetres of soil every 90 centimetres. So here's a broccoli look poking through. That behind me is the Isle of Wight. So I'm coming over here today to do another SPX set off. It's the 10th of March. Again with another big veg company. I'm not sure what the soil conditions will be like. But yeah, we're gonna have a play.
Okay, so we are strip tilling. So we set the strip till up in the field just by the farmyard there in that vetch and rye cover crop. And now we've gone out to get cracking on with this field. So this is just a stubble. It's quite a gravelly, sandy type soil. We're leaving them slightly elevated. So this will be left now until June. And then cauliflowers will come in here and be planted with a transplanter in June. So here on the Isle of Wight, Staples are a very big veg company. They're putting in about 20,000 acres plus of veg around the UK, but on the Isle of Wight there are about 1,000 acres in total. 700 of acres of that is cauliflower, and I think the rest of what they're doing is sweet corn. So the cauliflower here will go into the supermarkets. It will be planted in June and go into the supermarkets in December, January. So on the island the weather's quite mild, so they use this for later cauliflower because you don't get any frost damage that you might on the mainland further north. You see the row cleaners are just parting the trash out of the way. They're cleaning the row. We've got the deflector discs in at a bit of an angle, so we are leaving a bit of a berm. We're leaving it elevated. I don't know if that's quite showing on camera. It's not huge elevation. We're leaving it about an inch and a half, 2 inches above the soil. And yeah, like I say, that the row cleaners are parting all this trash really nicely. And yeah, very pleasing. So she's doing a good job. Show you what you were doing in the soil. Being the start of March, it is still quite wet at depth, so we're only running a low disturbance point. There's our worm, won't kill him. But we're going down to about 10 inches with that low disturbance point. This is a demo today, so that's what we're moving in the soil. We're gonna look to put the 8-row strip till in here in the autumn, and we'll probably put a wing on that so that we get a bit more fracturing into these sidewalls and loosen this up. But I wouldn't want a wing on there today because we would be bringing up an awful lot more clod because it is still quite wet and early in the season. So the lower disturbance point is fantastic for being able to run today. But when things dry up a bit more in the summer, we'd put that wing on. But what I'm really pleased with is how clean our rows are. The row cleaners have done a really good job in getting the trash out of the way. We have got the press wheels down. We have got a little bit of air pressing the press wheels down to about 15 psi, but relatively we can go to about 60-70 psi, so we're not putting an awful lot of pressure on the press wheels because we're wanting to leave the berm slightly elevated. So it's the 15th of March and I'm up in Lincoln today with Horizon's tractor and strip till. So we're doing another demo. This is ahead of sugar beet. So this land is very light, sandy soil. See just how, hopefully the camera picks up just how sandy it is. It had a stubble turnip cover crop put into it, so the sheep have been out here this winter, grazed it off, and now we're coming in with the SPX to create the strips for the sugar beet, which will go in next week. So you can see what we're doing. So we're going down to 9 inches with the strip till. This machine, so this is a, what we call a 6R50, so it's a 6-row machine on 50 centimetres. It's interesting, that 230 voucher's this isn't a test for it at all. It's purring along with it, but we're doing a really nice job. For this farmer, his big concern, so this is how they conventionally establish their sugar beets. So they would plow that and then, or subsoil that and plow it and then press it down firm. One of their big challenges is sand blow and stopping this sand from blowing away. So they're looking to get a bit more integrity in this soil. Yeah, so they're looking to get a bit more integrity in this soil and keep as much of the soil in the field as they can. We were discussing how heavy they've let the sheep graze it off, and to be honest, if they're wanting to stop sand blow, the best way they can do that is with having a living root in here to protect this soil and keep it all in. So if they go down this route, it is a demo, but they would be looking to have a much thicker cover crop in here to help protect this. But no, demo's really going really nice. On to the next one. Morning, it's West Sussex today. I'm down with Barfoots, who are fairly big veg growers down here. They have bought a 9-leg strip till, a 9-leg SPX, that they will be using predominantly for brassicas and sweet corn. So we are gonna set that up and get her running. So the Barfoot strip till is a 9-leg. We delivered it as a 9-leg at 60 centimetres, but we've decided we're going to be stripping for maize first, so they're going to need it as 8-leg at 75, so we're just adjusting all that. The plan is that this cultivator in the background, they are rebuilding for digestate, so that will also be 8-row 75, and they will have that on the back of the digestate tanker.
Kids, how it felt, the way you tasted. Even though your friends tell me you're doing fine, are you somewhere feeling lonely? Even though he's right beside you, when he says those words that hurt you, do you read the ones I wrote you? Sometimes I start to wonder, was it just a lie? If what we had is real, how could you be fine? 'Cause I'm not fine at all. Remember the day you told me.
We have got the strip till running, it's all going really nicely. I'm going to leave them to it now. The next job is getting that beauty running. This will be running in the strips, putting the digestate down. And then they'll be putting the Vibrotine kit on the strip till and planting the maize in behind. 25th of April, we're near Stonehouse in Gloucestershire. Mount with Talus Amos and a 4-row SPX, creating some strips ahead of maize. So you can just see the job the SPX is doing. So I put my little trusty trowel in, get head down there. We're running at about 8 inches at the moment. Might be tempted to put that down one more hole, but we've got a lovely tilth. If you dig in, you can see the tilth we're getting. We could put a wing on if we wanted to fracture this sidewall even more. We do 130mm and 160mm wings, so we could get into all of that. I actually think I'm gonna put it down another hole deeper. But this is the job we're doing. There is our strip for the maize. This is all the unmoved soil. And that's our strips for the maize. RTK is matching up nicely. We're on the 75 centimetres. Going very nicely. So the 215R John Deere is absolutely toying with that little four leg. That would handle an eight leg. She's going along at 12K. I've now put her in a bit deeper. She's now in. We'll be in at 9 inches now. And she's purring along at 12K at 14,000 RPM. So a little 140, 150 horsepower tractor would be fine with a four leg at 9 inches. So this is quite interesting. We moved to another field and this was an oats and vetch cover crop. It's much heavier land. And they had a demo of another strip till machine about a month ago when it was still too wet on heavy land. And nothing to do with the machine. I'm not going to say which manufacturer it was because that's not the point. The point is about timing. If you can see the job it's done, it struggled to make a seed bed. And that'll need another pass. We'll have a play with that, put the horizon in and see if we can make a seed bed out of it. But exactly the same soil a month later at the right time. And this is the seed bed that we're getting. So yeah, regardless of the machines, I've seen the job this machine's done in some lighter land. It's done a nice job. It's very much the difference is on timing. You see there, we're a long way from getting a maize seed bed there, but we're not far off here. I think the farmer's gonna have a go into this. So we've come back on this stuff that was done in a month ago and left it quite crude. We need to lift the leg up, it's still that down deep. I'll lift that at the end. Second pass, did a really nice job. So we are coming back in on a second pass on the RTK. We've lifted the leg to 5 inches, slowed him down a bit, put more pressure on the closing wheel. That's our seed bed.